And we say good morning to you. We're broadcasting live at American Import and Auto Repair, again, home of the Free Loaner Car Program. We're live on West Market Street in Johnson City on this Tuesday, January the 10th, 2017. Good morning to you. Hope all is well in your world. We are happy to report to you that checking the weather, Ben's going to give us a complete weather forecast, but checking the weather this morning, we will not be below freezing either daytime or nighttime through Monday through the extended forecast. Got some rain coming, he's going to tell us about, but as far as sub-freezing temperatures, ain't going to happen. Hit the bell. I'm all about that. Can you bring me spring, please? I'm ready to roll. Me, oh my. I'm over all this, but I know it's part of the four seasons and everything here in the mountains of East Tennessee, but I'm ready for springtime, and again, we're going to get that 60-degree temperatures later on in the week, but again, as we said, no sub-freezing temperatures daytime or nighttime through Monday, which is as far as the extended forecast goes. Good morning, too. We are live at American Import and Auto Repair here on AM 790 and also across Facebook Live, and yes, I do have my battery and my phone charger today, so that should not be a problem. Yes, that way. School of Hard Knocks lesson learned very quickly there on yesterday's show from Hardee's. Had a good time. Thanks, everybody, stopped by. They had a good response to the thick burgers, buy one, get one free, and we appreciate that as well. So today we are live at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Free Loaner Car Program. Birthdays today. Baseball Hall of Famer Willie McCovey having a birthday, 79. Boxing Hall of Famer and entrepreneur George Foreman is 68. A lot of folks know George Foreman more for his grills than he was or for his boxing talents, but that's how he all got started, of course, as a boxer. And so Foreman having a birthday, 68 today. Also Hall of Fame race car driver and team owner Bobby Rahal having a birthday, 64. In the music world, Rod Stewart having a birthday. Ben Foy, how old do you think Rod Stewart is today?
70.
Yep, 72 today. How about that? Tom Petty from Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers are actually in that band. Scott Thurston, never mind. I thought it was Tom Petty. Forget that one. Hall of Fame, singer Pat Benatar having a birthday, 64 today. But again, Rod Stewart having a birthday, 72 years young today and still out on tour, as a matter of fact. So, but the big sports one, of course, would be Willie McCovey, 79, and George Foreman, 68 today. So, as always, we dedicate the show to the man who hung on the cross. We unashamedly do that. Here is the verse to get us started today out of the book of Psalms. Psalms 46, verses 1, 2, and 3 says, I am your refuge and your strength. Even though the earth gives way, the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, do not fear. I am an ever-present help in trouble. How about right there? How can you not jump up and go on that kind of a Bible verse today? Again, I am an ever-present help in trouble. Psalms 46, 1, 2, and 3. Back to the studio we go. I'll tell you all, a game to be talking about. It was one for the ages last night, Clemson and Alabama. We'll talk about that. We're going to hear from Nick Saban. We're going to hear from Dabo Swinney from those two teams, of course. And we'll hear from their press conferences after the game a little bit later on here in the show. But first, let's go by and get an official weather forecast from our buddy Ben Foy, producer extraordinaire back at the studio. And what is our weather forecast, my friend, for the next couple of days? Absolutely, but this snow, once it melts, the snow melt will certainly help the water table, so that's going to be the good. And we had more rain coming, and we need it. And so it's going to be a rainy next couple of days, but a warm next couple of days. So,
By the way, we have a question today that came up on the general store.
Uh-oh.
Where does the white go when the snow melts?
Where does the white go? Where does the white go when the snow melts? Never thought of that. That's a good one. Where does the white go when the snow melts? That's interesting. So where does the white go when the snow melts? I have no clue. You ought to Google that and see what it tells you.
Yeah.
That's a good one. Where does the white go when the snow melts? That's way beyond me. I don't know. I guess it goes in the ground. So there you go. That's way over my head, and that's that's a little more than I can come up with. So anyway, that's what's going on. Uh-oh, Misty said what now?
It's the result of light reflected off frozen water molecules.
It is. She has the official statement, Mr. Foy. Would you like to come over here and tell us on the microphone, please, ma'am? What would be the official reason why?
Hand it to me so I can read it.
Oh, she can read it. Can you print it off?
Sure.
Print it off and she can come over and read it. We do have an answer. Where does the white go snow melt? See, this lady is smarter than the average bear. She's like boo-boo. Oh, boo-boo. She's smarter than the average bear. Did you grow up watching? She what? She has looks and brains. Yes, she does. She is smarter than the average bear. So she has the answer. And that's a very, very good question. Where does the snow, or does the white go in snow melt? She can put those on just like that. Yeah, we got you on a headset today. We're live here. We're going to be talking about this game of all games. Can you pull that down right yonder? And there you go. And how are you? Can we hear your golden tones?
Hello.
There she is. We hear her. Okay. Turn her up a little bit. We can do that. All right. Our buddy Misty Brown, the customer service rep here at American Import and Auto Repair. So go ahead. What is the official rule, or not ruling, but statement, where does the white go in snow melts? And you say...
It does just melt.
Yeah.
The only reason it's white is because of the result of light reflected off frozen water molecules.
As a result of light frozen off...
Because so the snow isn't really white. It only appears to be white.
There you go. It's not really white, Ben. It only appears to be white. And then what happens?
The crystals change form and become liquid.
Become liquid. There we go. Let me see. Wow. See there? Took a lady. Whereabouts is it here?
The very top.
There it is. White is a result of light Oh, yeah.
You're very welcome. She's
on it, like white on rice, or in this case, like white on snow. There we go. White is a result of light reflected off frozen water molecules. The snow isn't really white. It only appears white. When the snow melts, the crystals change form and become liquid. There you go. See? If you don't learn anything else today on this show, you now learn why snow appears to be white. And where does the white go in the snow melt? She typed it in and got the answer. How are you doing, by the way?
I'm good.
Now that you're here, why don't you just go ahead and do your spiel today? You doing good?
I am doing good.
Yes. Now, guys, after the snow and all that from yesterday and today, so you've had, I see you've got the Donahoe vehicle out here working. You've had oil changes. What else have you been doing down here so far?
That's pretty much it. Just doing the service.
Yep. Oil changes. What are the guys back here doing? What are they working on?
Different, a lot of stuff.
Yeah, brakes.
Yep, brakes, alignments, getting a lot of alignments.
Front wheel alignments, mm-hmm. Yeah. You helped Ben with a windshield wiper blade yesterday.
Sure did.
There you go. Front end alignments, oil changes, been selling some tars.
Sure have.
As Scott says it, he says tars, been selling some tars. Very good. So
a little bit of everything.
Yeah.
And some Super Savers. Thank you.
Sold some Super Savers.
Sure have.
In fact, you're going to come back. I kind of caught her here with the snow thing, but when you come back with your cheat sheet, let's talk about Super Saver a little while. Can you
sure.
do that? Will you do that?
Yep.
All right. Come back here in a few minutes. She is so nice, Ben Foy, I tell you. So what do you say? She not only has the looks, but she has the brains. Is that what you said? There you go. All right. Very good. Isn't he so kind? He's so nice. We are live at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Free Loaner Car Program. Did you watch the game last night, Ben Foy? Hello, Jerry Keller. Thank you, my friend, for checking in with us on Facebook. Did you watch the game last night?
Yes, I did.
Would you rate that as one of the all-time best football games, college football games?
I would. After that first half, I was ready to start the show with steamroller Steamroller was the
I guarantee you. It was unbelievable. And we're going to hear from Saban. One of the national journalists have already started picking on Saban as far as saying, you know, why did you play Jalen Hurts? Now, let's face it. The guy, look what he did with his football team all year long. So now he had a bad game. He's a freshman. And so now, you know, the good old armchair quarterbacks are coming out saying, well, he should have been playing a freshman quarterback. Well, yeah, sounds good now. But, you know, when he was leading the victories all year long as a freshman and how fabulous he was and how this and how that, it was okay. But when he has a so-so ball game, And all of a sudden it's like, well, you know, there's, you're questioning why he played a freshman quarterback. You know, of course he earned the start. That's why Saban puts the best ones out there. But you cannot take away what Clemson did last night and Deshaun Watson and heck of a football game. Last year's college football playoff championship game was a classic. This year's was even better. Clemson got its revenge for Alabama. Deshaun Watson hit Hunter Renfrow for a two-yard touchdown pass with 1 second to play as the Tigers edged the Crimson Tide 35-31 last night in Tampa. The win gave Clemson its second national title in football and its first since 1981. The winning score capped a 9-play, 68-yard drive that was made necessary after Alabama's freshman quarterback Jalen Hurts scampered 30 yards to put the Tide up 31-28 with 2:07 to play. Gave them too much time, and right back down the field they came. Of course, nobody's talking about the defensive interference call that got them down to the goal line. I mean, that was a huge play in the game by Alabama's defender. They had them backed up. When I say backed up, they had them, inside the 15-yard line. I can't remember exactly where it was the ball was placed, but with the penalty, put it down around the goal line. And so they punch it in for the touchdown. So the interference call against Alabama was huge. Nobody's saying much about that, but that was obviously a very pivotal play in a football game. In two games against Alabama, the most ferocious defense in college football, Deshaun Watson has thrown for 825 yards and accounted for 8 touchdowns in 2 years against Alabama. In all, Clemson put up 511 yards in the Crimson Tide and held the ball for nearly 35 minutes. In a fitting ending, Watson took the game's final snap in the victory formation after Clemson recovered the squib kick that followed Renfrow's winning touchdown. So, No, you're exactly right. Crimson. Crimson Tide appeared to be in control entering the final 15 minutes. He took a 24-14 lead late in the third quarter after O.J. Howard took advantage of a Clemson blown coverage and had a 68-yard catch and run from Hurts for a touchdown. Clemson came roaring back in the fourth. First, Watson cut the deficit to 24-21 with a 4-yard touchdown pass to Mike Williams. Then Wayne Gallman surged over the goal line from a yard out to give the Tigers a 28-24 lead with 4:38 to go in the ballgame. But here comes Alabama right back down the field. The offense, which had gone dormant for most of the second half, came to life with the help of a sweet call from newly promoted offensive coordinator Steve Sarkisian. Receiver Ardarius Stewart took a backward pass from Hurts and then fired a strike to O.J. Howard for 24 yards. Right back down the field they come, though. Watson responded like a two-time Heisman Trophy finalist, hitting Williams and Jordan Leggett for great catches and big gains before, here we go, the Alabama pass interference penalty set up Clemson with a first and goal to 2 with 6 seconds to play. So Alabama tonight is in its quest for back-to-back playoff titles as well as a chance to become the first 15-win major college football team since Pennsylvania did it back in 1897. Nick Saban remained stuck on 5 BCS or playoff titles. He would have matched the championship total of another Tuscaloosa legend, Bear Bryant, with a win on Monday night. So we'll continue more on that, and we've got a story about what went wrong in this game for Alabama. We're going to hear from Dabo Sweeney. We're going to hear from Nick Saban later in the show. Right now we're going to hear from my man, the one, the only, Scott Hyatt. Good morning, sir. How are you? Good. Did you watch the game?
Thank you.
Off and on, in and out?
Until I fell asleep.
There you go. So, you know.
I'm just being real, brother. I fell asleep.
So here's a question. National championship football game. Why don't we start at 8:30 on a work night? I mean, I can see a Friday night or a Saturday night, but, you know, folks do have to go to bed and get up and go to work. Why would you not start it at 7:30?
Can I be real?
Yeah, go ahead.
I wouldn't have rednecked it and decided that one, brother.
I know that.
But I'd have probably done it about 6 o'clock. We'd eat good and get crazy.
There you go. Well.
But they don't pay me the large amount
to
make those decisions.
Me either, but I'm just thinking, okay, because, you know, it's after midnight. It's a heck of a football game with all the timeouts and the lengthy halftime. And so you're talking, and game's over 12:30, maybe 20-1. And,
right.
You know, national championship. Start a little bit earlier so everybody can watch it. You know, how many school kids didn't get a chance to watch a heck of a finish because they had to get up and go to school? So.
Well, a lot of kids are out of school, though.
Well, that's true. Good point. Yeah, I never thought of that.
I don't think they were thinking that
way. No. So, anyway, great ball game. We're going to talk more about it because we're just getting started recovering and hashing and rehashing what went wrong, what's going on with this national championship. 35-31 final. Clemson again over the Alabama Crimson Tide. What's going on here at American Import and Auto Repair today, my friend? Busy?
All kinds of fun stuff. Fixing cars, brother.
Fixing cars. What we got about you? I know you got the Donahoe.
Well, let me think. We got a, let me go down the list. Got a Nissan Maxima in the first bay, a Mustang in the second bay. Getting brakes.
What's Maxima getting?
Maxima is possessed by the devil. We're trying it's got all kinds of critters and cars. Yeah, you didn't know cars could get possessed
by
the devil, did you?
No, I didn't know. I learned something new.
Yeah, if you don't take care of them, they get crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So you got a Maxima Bay 1, number 2 Mustang.
Yeah, let me go down through this list here. Maxima Bay 1, possessed by devil. Bay 2, Mustang getting brakes. Brake system flush. Bay 3, there is a commercial van being worked on. Wait a minute, lie to you. Trouble getting the steering rack and pinion, power steering lines, fourth bay. It's a commercial truck. I got a BMW back there getting some stuff. You know what BMW stands for, don't you?
Be my.
Break my wallet.
Bring
more wallet. Yeah.
Bring more wallet, all right.
Yeah, just being real.
There you go.
Love BMWs.
Yeah.
That was anyway.
So you got one of those working on it. What are you doing to the BMW
is having crankcase issues, camshaft mm-hmm. position, camshaft, crankshaft position sensors replaced, a lot of drivability issues, oil leaks. BMWs like to leak oil when the crankcase pressure gets too high. They're not happy.
Hmm.
That's the way I am. Get too much pressure and start leaking. Got you laughing on that, didn't I?
Oh my. What else? What are the other bays you got? Is that it?
Let me think. You've mentioned Donna Hope. Let me think. There's all kinds of stuff. We got stuff taken. We got a F-150 truck back there. It's also possessed by the devil. Somebody tried to work on it, though.
Yeah.
It's kind of unique. People work on their own stuff. And it's just a word of advice. If you start working on it and you work a little bit and can't figure it out, don't spend $2,000 more and try to work on it and figure out you're going to spend... Yeah, because sometimes people cause more problems.
Bring somebody who knows what's going on, like right here.
Well, that's why you're not going to have me do your plumbing.
There you go. Amen. Or your electrical work.
I can do electrical, but not good. I'm iron, not an electrician.
But don't do plumbing.
You've got to know, and this is being serious, you got to know your limits. And sometimes some people's limits are 100 yards away. They should stop.
We're talking to Scott Hyde again, American Import and Auto Repair. Coming up, we're going to hear from Dabo Swinney and Nick Saban about the game last night and what went wrong for Alabama, and obviously what went right for Clemson. And also, I got this story where somebody's already picking apart Saban because he's played a freshman quarterback all year, which is ridiculous to criticize. Well, I think it is. Maybe not, but he did pretty good for 14 games. So
everybody, it's easy for somebody to say,
exactly. Thank you.
Quarterback, and
there you go. There you go. It's easy to sit back and pick them apart after the fact, but
yeah. Drinking beer and eating Cheetos, you're a winner. Anyway, I'm just throwing that in there.
Oh, so tell me again about American Import and Auto Repair. Tim came by yesterday when we were at Hardee's, talking about you guys have worked with a lot of folks, have had the tire pressure indicator come on the car. Tell me about that.
Yeah, when it gets cold outside, your air pressure and your tires will contract a little bit. And we see people coming in with tire pressure monitoring sensors kicking on. It's just a matter of airing them up and setting them right and resetting the sensor. Not a big deal in most cases.
Yeah. Also coming up, we got some football signees for East Tennessee State football. Coach Torbush out beating the bushes. Right. And he's got some two new recruits we'll tell you about. Also some college basketball. It's a big night for the hoops tonight. National Hockey League, NBA. All that right here at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loan a car program. And so... let's see, I was going to ask you one more thing before you took off here. We were talking about the tire pressure. Oh, we've got a break. We had a weather forecast. We're going to be above freezing both nighttime and daytime all the way through Monday for the extended forecast. So we have a break in the action. You know more winter weather's coming. February is notorious for winter weather. So what should we do now? Come down here and let you guys get our vehicles ready to go for more winter driving because there's more coming. What should we do? We got through this first round. What do we need to do between now and the next round?
Get your tires checked first and foremost to make sure you got plenty of tread. Make sure you got a strong battery so when you get out and it's 5 degrees that you're not cussing in your breath because it'll start the car.
Right.
Also check your antifreeze because see it often on where people will not, you know, you got a car that's 8 or 10 years old and never flushed out the antifreeze or checked the pH level on it, then you can be confident the freeze point that's under 32, then voila, it gets cold and it can freeze.
If you have any trouble, just give me a
call. Doesn't have much, but it does happen. Also, I'll talk a little bit about preparedness. You know, when you get into this rough weather, you need to be thinking about having stuff in the back of your car, like a flashlight, a blanket, some kitty litter, a few things, some jumper cables. It's using your head a little bit. Be prepared. I'm a Boy Scout.
There you go. Some granola bar, something like that, because if you get out and get stuck somewhere, and you know, you got to kind of survive for a little while inside the vehicle, you got something to,
make sure
to chew
you
on.
Got your gas full, because that's the one thing I heard last year. I had a buddy of mine, he said they were calling for snow, and I waited and got out with about a quarter tank and got stuck in traffic, and guess what? He ran out of gas.
Ran out of gas, yep.
Said $75 tow bill and unhappy. Mama unhappy.
You replaced batteries this week?
Oh, yeah. We've done a lot of batteries. I mean, yeah. We're doing a whole bunch of batteries, and if you got a four-wheel drive, make sure it works.
The time
you find out when it's working is when you need to pull out 6 inches of snow.
It's not working.
And it's about that.
There you go. My man, Scott Hyatt, appreciate you, Mo. Good brother.
So, yeah, man, I appreciate you.
Appreciate you, too. Now, did you hear what we learned today, why the snow is not white? It is really not white. So, we found this out. Where does the white go when the snow melts? Was the question posed, and so Misty had the answer. She looked it up, she Googled it, and it says, white is a result of light reflecting off frozen water molecules. The snow isn't really white, it only appears white. When the snow melts, the crystals change form, become liquid.
I knew that.
You knew that?
I'm just going to work with eyes.
Yeah.
Be leery of the yellow snow. That's
the
yellow. Hey, I hear him laughing.
That's Ben, yeah. You fixed him yesterday. Fixed his windshield wiper blade.
Yeah,
came back and
I didn't get a chance to talk to him. I was back in the back talking to somebody.
Beware of yellow snow.
Yeah, do not eat the yellow snow.
There you go.
It does not make snow cream. It makes vomit.
There you go. On that note, say goodbye. We went from yellow snow to vomit, so we're gone.
I'm going to leave now.
That's time to go. Yeah, we got to roll. Yeah. We got sports.
I'm like the in-laws. Got to go.
Got to go. Say goodbye, Scott.
See you, buddy.
All right, there you go. We're getting down to vomit and yellow snow. We're out. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. We're going to talk sports. We're going to hear from Nick Saban. We're going to hear from Dabo Swinney. And we're going to go down this article about why the Alabama quarterback should have been playing, for heaven's sakes. It's just amazing how people can second guess. And that's what this guy's done. And I'll see what his name is. Dieter. I'll find out. I get his name. Dieter Ohlenbach or something like that. I'll double check and see what this guy's name is. But anyway, I don't guess the fact of who it is really makes any difference. No, I'm not even sure it even matters. But it's just really, to me, it's humorous to question a man, you know, in a system that's done what they've done. They got beat, and so now all of a sudden they start picking them apart when half of the people want to get beat because they're tired of winning. So when they do lose, like, oh, yeah, see, here's why he got beat. It's like, it's just always something that just amazes me. But anyway, quick break. We'll be right back. We're live at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program, and also home of the Super Saver Maintenance Club. We'll be right back, and we will hear from Alabama coach Nick Saban next here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Hey, Facebook folks, thank you for being with us. Be sure and go to TomTaylorSports.com, your one-stop shop. You can listen to the radio station there. You can listen here. Click on Facebook Live. Like us and share us, please, and you have been, and we thank you for that. So we're going to be talking and hearing from Saban in a few minutes, and it's amazing to me that they would even question. But it's easy to do. As Scott said, the morning after and the armchair quarterback, it's easy to second-guess and question what's going on. So crazy, crazy stuff, I can tell you that. But that's okay. That's why we're here, and that's why we have this show. So we're going to come back with you here in a few minutes. And do you have the Super Saver Maintenance Club? Do you have one of them little flyers, one of them flowers? Oh, there it is right here. Thank you. You're so good. I'll put it back. Yep. Oh, did you get a Super Saver Maintenance Club?
You can have a cut
too. Good. So, there you go. Smart man. So, folks on Facebook, $519 value for only $99. You get, 14 different discounts or specials, if you will. And this is through 13 months. You get it now. It's good through January of next year, 2018. Can't beat it. Plus, it can be shared with multiple vehicles, too. So, good stuff. So, that's, you get 4 oil changes, 2 tire rotations, a complete car inspection, bumper to bumper, a free brake system inspection, all this for $99. If you came in and paid for all this, it's $519. But with this Super Saver Maintenance Club, it's for $99. It's right here at American Import and Auto Repair. By the way, the phone number, you can call and talk to Misty or Scott or Blaine at 913-3111 is the number to call. There's Mrs. Smith. She's in the house. Hello. How are you? How about them Steelers? How about them Steelers? Boy, she's grinning like a fox in a hen house. How about them Steelers?
I didn't say anything because they were playing the Dolphins. You know who loves the Dolphins?
Oh. I'm sorry, what? What, Ben? Okay. All right. All right. I think it's got a short in it, so. Yeah. Back on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Thanks for being with us again. American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Super Saver Maintenance Club for $99. This is what you can get. And a lot of folks have been coming out and getting these. And why would you not? It's a $519 value for only $99. It can be shared with multiple vehicles. Again, it's good for 13 months. You get it this month, and it's good through February of 2018. So it's a no-brainer. You get four oil changes. Four oil changes, and attached to those are two tire rotations. All this is free. A complete car inspection, bumper to bumper, $15 off a transmission service, $10 off a coolant flush, $15 off a BG fuel induction cleaning service. This is over the next 13 months. $30 off a single invoice over $300. Free wiper blade with the purchase of a wiper blade. Free tire repair, puncture, or bead sealing service. Free alignment. All this, again, 14 different things you get for only $99. It's a maintenance program for your vehicle. And whether you have a pickup truck or a SUV or a station wagon or a two-door pocket rocket, whatever you got, it's good for any of those. And so it's here, and it's good anytime you buy it now. As we said, it's good through February of next year. And so a $519 value for only $99. It's the Super Saver Maintenance Club. Bill Lister got one in gray. I know that. Ben Foy got one that our producer extraordinaire came down and bought one. So it's a no-brainer, really, for what you can get, what you do get over the next 13 months. Plus, as we said, it can be shared with multiple vehicles in the family household. So, good stuff. All right, let's jump in and talk about this. Why Alabama got beat. The results were undeniable. Again, Jalen Hurts became the first Saban quarterback. This is why they got beat, according to this one guy, because Hurts was the quarterback. Unbelievable. Became the first Saban quarterback to throw for 300 yards and rush for 100 yards in the same game. Alabama's offense was one of the best and most balanced in college football. And so it didn't matter that Hurts had a poor game in the playoff against Washington. But Hurts had another poor performance last night. Hurts had a stellar 30-yard touchdown run to give Alabama a lead with roughly 2 minutes to play. Yeah, that's pretty big for a freshman. But the best pass of that six-play, 68-yard touchdown drive came from wide receiver Ardarius Stewart on a double pass play that found O.J. Howard for a 24-yard gain. Hurts had been so poor passing the ball to that point in the game, a late point in the fourth quarter, that offensive coordinator Steve Sarkisian, the element of surprise aside, trusted a receiver to pass the ball downfield more than a starting quarterback. Hurts, 13 out of 31 for 131 yards and a touchdown. So all of a sudden, this guy now is, you know, why did you play him? Which I just find amazing. Much will be made of Nick Saban's decision to fire offensive coordinator Lane Kiffin last week and replace him with Sarkisian, the former Washington USC head coach and an Alabama offensive analyst, for the most important game of the year. Alabama outplayed, and Ben said this. He said he was going to play the Steamroller Blues today because Alabama outplayed Clemson for at least the first three quarters of the game. But Alabama's inability to move the ball in the second half of the game, save for the final offensive drive, left the door open for a Clemson comeback. And so as a result, they are blaming the freshman quarterback, Jalen Hurts, in this case, Saban, for playing Hurts. So, Ben, here's my question, buddy. If you run with him all year long, there's no reason why you wouldn't run with him in the championship. Why would you pull him then?
You would.
Exactly.
You go with the one that got you to the dance.
It's this guy, this writer, and I can't find his name on the byline. It's not in here.
It doesn't matter anyway.
It doesn't matter. But I mean, it's amazing that, you know, and I'm not taking anything away from Clemson. Clemson won the ball game. They earned it. They deserved to win very much. And they outplayed Alabama down the stretch, and they won the game, and they should have. But to come back and start picking apart why Alabama lost and to use Jalen Hurts as the reason is ridiculous. Let me tell you the reason why. You have Deshaun Watson in two games, not this game alone, but last year's game too. What I read earlier, 811 yards of offense in two games. Make sure I read that right. 811 yards of offense in two ball games for Deshaun Watson against the Alabama defense, which some say was the best in the country. Well, right there is your, if you're going to point fingers, you couldn't stop them. And Saban's about to tell you that we scored 31 points in the football game. Should have been enough to win the game. 31 points, you know, he said, and, you know, this is a team that shut out Ohio State last week, 31-0. So we held them to 31 or 35 points, and we scored 31. We should have won the ball game. So, and, you know, that's a point well taken. So, anyway, to blame Jalen Hurts for the loss, nah. Is that, that's ridiculous. It's he didn't have a good game, absolutely, but here it is. In two games against Alabama, the most ferocious defense in college football, Deshaun Watson has thrown for 825 yards and accounted for 8 touchdowns. Clemson put up 511 yards on the Crimson Tide defense and held the ball for nearly 35 minutes last night. And oh, by the way, they ran 99 plays against Alabama. That ain't Jalen Hurts, I can tell you that. That has nothing to do with a freshman quarterback. It has everything to do with the defense, or in this case, the Clemson offense. I mean, you know, Deshaun Watson, arguably so, is the best player in college football. He proved that last night on the national, you know, take his case in point, take his performance last night when the chips were on the line, he produced. Look at Odell Beckham on Sunday for the New York Giants. 4 catches, 28 yards, dropped the ball in the end zone, punches a hole in the wall after the game and bangs his head against the wall. Why are you comparing him? Because in big games, the big guys step up and make big plays. Look what Aaron Rodgers did on Sunday against the New York Giants. Look what Roethlisberger did, the Steelers against the Dolphins. Big players make big games on the big stage. And yeah, I mean, Jalen Hurts had didn't have a real good game as a freshman, but that was not the reason Alabama got beat. Deshaun Watson came. He was a man among boys. I mean, the guy put on a show. It's just real simple. But to blame Jalen Hurts individually for that loss, or to blame it on Saban or Sarkisian for playing him, why?
And his cage rattled a few times in the first half there, and everybody was kind of wondering about it, but he proved them all
wrong. Yeah. Another big play, another big factor in this football game, Bo Scarborough, 16 carries, 93 yards, 2 touchdowns, averaging 6 yards a carry. Goes out with a leg injury. So, you know, there would be another obvious that Scarborough was absent of the second half when he got hurt. That's huge. So anyway, to blame Jalen Hurts is just ridiculous. Watson last night, here's his numbers, passing. 36 out of 56. Threw the ball 56 times against Alabama. Completed him 36 out of 56. 420 yards and 3 touchdowns and no interceptions. That's a man among boys. That's a guy that stepped up on the big game, on the big stage, and produced. I mean, 420 yards, 3 touchdowns, no interceptions. And he also threw to 6 different receivers last night. Renfro, Williams, Leggett, Kane, Gallman, and Scott. 6 different guys got the football, so he sprayed it all over the field, obviously. So Deshaun Watson was the man among boys and won the football game. It was nothing to do with Jalen Hurts, or lack thereof, what he did not do. What we're about to hear, or who we're about to hear from, is Alabama head coach Nick Saban. Here we go. Let's see what he has to say about the game last night here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. And here is Alabama head coach Nick Saban.
Something else that I could do for the players to help them be more successful. but to the older team of seniors, their leadership has been commendable all season long. And these guys have accomplished a tremendous amount of success for the University of Alabama in the years that they've been between three straight SEC championships and the playoffs in 3 years to the
And we apologize. That audio is not very good, and I apologize for that. That's on me. And so, Ben, that's not very good, is it? No, I apologize, and that's on me for the equipment had a little malfunction here. So we'll clean it up and we'll run it back for you tomorrow. And tomorrow will be just as good today as to hear what he had to say. And of course, he'll probably have more to say between now and then. But again, we, for whatever reason, I'm sitting listening to him thinking, that ain't going to cut it. So anyway, we will trudge on, and we will hear from Dabo Swinney tomorrow. And we will hear also tomorrow from Nick Saban here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. And we're live again at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Free Loaner Car Program. Again, thanks for being with us again on this Tuesday. I'm trying to tweak this thing while I'm going. I apologize. I've turned the wrong knobs, and so I'm trying to. Does it sound better now? Is it okay? All right, my bad. So anyway, we're back, and we apologize about the technical quality of the interviews, and we will have it fixed tomorrow. And that's on me. So on Ben. We appreciate and apologize. Biggest game of the year. It should have been better, and that's on me. And so now I'm not happy. I'm not happy with me. So Tigers snapping Alabama's 26-game winning streak dating back to 2015 as Deshaun Watson and the company gave Clemson its first title since 1981. What went wrong, I guess, for Alabama? Number one, for the season, Alabama allowed opponents to score touchdowns in only 38% of red zone trips, third in the nation. Last night, Clemson inside the 20, 4-for-4, perfect. We go back to the game on Sunday between the Packers and the Giants. They were inside the 35, four times and got, or three times, and came out of there with 6 points. So when you get down in there, you got to produce, and Clemson did. They were 4-for-4 on converting trips inside the Alabama 20 in touchdowns. The Tide had only allowed 8 red zone touchdowns in 14 games, red zone again being inside the 20-yard line. But Watson and the Clemson offense able to get 50% of that season total in 60 minutes on Monday night. That is point number one. Point number two, Alabama's points off 2 Clemson turnovers. Clemson put the ball on the ground twice by way of fumbles, one after a wayward snap and the other after Wayne Gallman was stripped by Ryan Anderson. However, unlike 9 other teams this season, the Tigers were able to prevent the Alabama defense from immediately turning those turnovers into 6 points. Hunter Renfro's tackle of Ryan Anderson, what could have been a scoop and score, proved huge in the football game. Another reason Alabama lost, the number of total plays run by Clemson. Alabama's defense had not faced more than 85 plays all season. Arkansas had the most plays against them, 84. Clemson able to wear down the mighty Tide defense with a tempo and consistent movement on offense. Alabama, by the way, only ran 66 plays on offense compared to Clemson running 99. Ben, that's a difference of 33 plays. If you're out on the field for 33 more plays than I am, good chance you're going to get tired, wouldn't you think? There you go. 99 plays by Clemson, 66 plays ran by Alabama. That's a huge difference. Clemson offense averaging 5.7, caught 6 yards per play in the second half, only 4.5 yards per play in the first half. So they warmed up. Again, this ain't got nothing to do with Jalen Hurts. It's got everything to do with the Alabama defense or the Clemson offense, combination thereof. Clemson picked up 21 first downs in the second half after only 10 first downs in the first half. So again, Alabama push up front was not as strong, only 2 tackles for loss in the second half. And the lack of pressure, I mean, Watson pretty much roamed free back there in the backfield. And the lack of pressure allowed him to complete. In the second half of the football game, Deshaun Watson was 23 out of 34 passing the football. Now, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out where this game was decided. It was on number 4 shoulders, Deshaun Watson. This guy could do it. Alabama's third down conversion offensively. This should go back to Hurts sputtering a little bit. They were 2 for 15 in third down conversions. 2 for 13. I'm sorry, 2 for 15. 2 for 15. 2 for 15. Third down conversions. You're not going to beat anybody. And even in the game, it's pretty phenomenal. To be down there for three third down tries, you have 15, you convert 2. That tells you a lot right there. And then finally, the number of Clemson receivers with more than 90 yards receiving. Mike Williams, Jordan Leggett, Deion Kane, and of course Hunter Renfrow. We had 10 catches, 92 yards, and 2 touchdowns, including the game winner. Mike Williams, big night, 8 catches, 94 yards, and 1 touchdown. Jordan Leggett, 7 catches for 95 yards. And Deion Kane, 5 catches for 94 yards, had big nights as well. Bottom line is, Clemson outplayed Alabama in the second half and won the football game. It's real, real simple. This is not... There you go. Deshaun Watson, second half, 23 out of 34 passing in the second half. They had 21 first downs in the second half. They ran 99 plays compared to Alabama's 66 for the whole ball game. There's your game right there, 35-31 final. The fact that Alabama's even in the game, that playing it that close, in fact, they had the lead right down to the end, as you know, if you watched the game. But the fact that it was even close is obviously a testament to Alabama because, you know, Clemson ran 33 more plays. If I have 33 more chances in a football game to score points than my opposition, I feel pretty good about it. So Clemson, 99 plays, Alabama, 66 plays. But Deshaun Watson was a man among boys. Watson was a difference, obviously, in the football game last night. Not Jalen Hurts, not Bo Scarborough. It was Deshaun Watson, plain and simple. Oh, yeah, they're out there longer. I mean, 33 more plays, and their tongues are hanging out, I guess. I mean, that's what it pretty much said. In the second half, the Alabama up front couldn't get pressure on him. They only had 2 tackles for loss, which is very uncommon for Alabama. And so Watson's back there in the second half, 23 out of 34 passing the football. There's some guys don't have a whole game that good, and he did it just in one half. So big night. Clemson wins it fair and square, 35-31 to stop the string of the Alabama Crimson Tide. Saban said, although you couldn't hear it, and I apologize again about that, but Saban said, we're going back to work today to get ready for next year. And he continued to say in his post-game press conference, very, very, very disappointed. He said that once. He said it about 3 or 4 times that they got beat and the way they got beat. So if I had to point fingers, and I'm not going to because it's just a great football game, the better team won, but if you look at where things came up short, there's no question Alabama's defensive secondary had some major holes to let a guy sit back there and throw for, what, 420 yards, as I said, and in the second half go 23 for 34 in the second half alone. That's not offense, folks. That's defense or the lack thereof. So if there's a area that Alabama's got a question today, they go back and watch the film, it would be, as we said, the defense, and in particular the secondary. Because Watson had a field day. And this guy's it's the reason why he's a Heisman Trophy finalist 2 years in a row. Quick break. We'll be right back with more. We've got other sports to talk about. We'll take a look at East Tennessee State Buccaneer football. They've got a couple of the new recruits on board, and we'll tell you all about that, who they are, where they're coming in from, and more as we're live at American Import and Auto Repair on the Tom Taylor Sports Show on AM 790 and also on Facebook Live. Well... Is it sounding okay now?
You sound good now.
Yeah. Why did the audio not work? I took it straight off of ESPN. Jiminy Christmas. I guess I just need to run the rule of thumb. We'll run everything, but send it back over to you. But I couldn't. I didn't pull it up to 8 o'clock this morning because they didn't bring it out until after I went to bed. So, Facebook Live, folks. Again, sorry about the audio. Facebook, of course, you couldn't have heard it anyway. But Facebook Live, TomTaylorSports.com. We appreciate you going there and sharing and liking it, and so that is something we're very, very proud of. So like us, and as we said, please share us. The show continues to grow by leaps and bounds on both the radio and the Facebook, and we thank you for that profusely. So please continue to do that, and we'll come right back, and we'll be ready to roll with some more sports. Again, talking ETSU Buccaneer football coming up here in just a second. pulls my ripcord. I mean, listen to this.
Sorry for all that we didn't finish. But...
hear that?
Next question will take right down here in Mary front. That's fine. We'll take it over here to left.
Dan Wetzel, Yahoo Sports, for coach.
Hear that?
If any presented themselves, what were the challenges of changing offensive coordinators, and how do you think you guys handled it this week and in tonight? Well, I think the players handled it very well. I think we scored 31 points in the game.
Well, he was scratchy. What is our time?
11:49.
11:46:22.
Oh, okay.
Back on the Top Thrill Sports Show. Thanks for being with us live at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program. We got 13 minutes to the top of the hour. Let's take a look at East Tennessee State Buccaneer football, how things went with them. They have some recruits signed up, and that's good news for Carl Torbush. The Buccaneer football team ended up having a great year this past year, and so let's see who these folks are. Kamen Cooper, 6'2", 205 defensive back out of Warner Robins, Georgia. Butler Community College finished with 16 tackles, 4 tackles for loss, 1 interception and a half a sack in 9 games for the Grizzlies. And so he was named the defensive back player of the year there in that community college league. Played high school ball at Warner Robins, where he finished with 88 tackles, 1.5 sacks and an interception in 2015. His cousin Cam Martin is a freshman running back at Auburn. So Kamen Cooper, 6'2", 205 out of Georgia, now going to be a Buccaneer at East Tennessee State. At defensive back at 6'2", 205, a pretty sized defensive back. Then the tight end they signed out of Blinn Community College in Texas, Evan Wick, 6'4", 240. There's a hoss. Good grief. Tight end, total 39 tackles, 6 tackles for loss, 4 sacks, and 3 forced fumbles in 2016 as the defensive end. Says tight end, but you can't be making tackles if you're a tight end. I guess you can, but that's usually when the team stole the ball and went the other way. So that's a typo. It's defensive end. Recorded season high 8 tackles against 4 different teams. His brother's a rookie tight end for the Detroit Lions. That would be Colwick. And his other brother, Cullen, is a freshman defensive lineman at Blinn Community College. So 6'4", 240 defensive end. Again, played defensive end. 39 tackles, 6 tackles for loss, 4 sacks, and 3 forced fumbles in 2016. So, 2 Buccaneers, they picked up 2 guys, 6'2", 205, Kamen Cooper out of Warner Robins, Georgia, a defensive back, and then defensive end, Evan Wick, 6'4", 240. I'd say he's chiseled. I'd say he's built like a rock, Ben. Boy, what do you think?
Yeah, I'd say so.
6'4", 240. That's a pretty good size youngin', so...
I wouldn't want to run into that wall.
No, I believe I'll just stay right over here and wave at him as he runs by. So there you go. More college football, actually more pro football. The general manager of the New York Giants has come out against Odell Beckham, says time for him to grow up. I love this. Beckham failed to handle a couple of Eli Manning's passes on Sunday, finishing the game with 4 catches and 28 yards. After the loss, Beckham reportedly punched a hole in the wall. He was then forced to defend his decision to party with Justin Bieber in Miami earlier in the week, as if that trip was really the reason why he struggled to catch the football. But again, it was just not a real good weekend for Beckham Jr. Giants general manager yesterday, Jerry Reese's turn to weigh in on Beckham's actions, which include the whole kicking thing and some reported fines. And he says, quote, "I see a guy who needs to think about some of the things that he does. Everybody knows he's a gifted player, but there have been some things that he's done that he needs to look himself in the mirror and be honest with himself about some of the things that he's done. I think he'll do that. We'll help him with that." Yeah, I'm sure you will. But he has to help himself, and we believe he'll do that. He's a smart guy, but sometimes he does not do smart things. So there you go. Ben, when you bang your head against the wall after an interview, after a ball game, not your hands, your head up against the wall repeatedly, and then punch a hole in the wall, it's time to make some changes, wouldn't you think?
Well, you are addressing the problem where it's at, for one thing.
Yeah. And then his head, oh, hit the bell. That's good. You're exactly right. So, problem, you got it. So that's tough stuff there again for Odell Beckham Jr. Again, we'll run down the NFL playoffs coming up here in just a little while. Hey, don't forget one of our great sponsors, Solgar. Again, 20% off at Max Medicine Mart in Kingsport. Everything Solgar this month, 20% off at Max. And again, there's no coupons, no specials, no limits. It's just a flat 20% off anytime and every time you go in and shop at Max Medicine Mart in Kingsport. We're going to be there later on the month broadcasting live. And again, it's a flat 20% off. Some of the things under the Solgar line, they sell a bunch of the Formula V, as in Victor. Excellent multivitamin. Again, it's 20% off. Standardized herbs, solarium, oregano, which is a natural antibiotics. And it's good for the cough and good for the croup. Oregano, they got that, a standardized herb. It's 20% off. Bilberry, olive leaf, those are some of the herbs that are 20% off this month under the umbrella of Solgar. And then the B12, the vitamin B12. This particular vitamin B12 melts under your tongue, so it is absorbed virtually instantly. And so Solgar, 20% off the entire month at Max Medicine Mart in Kingsport. Make tracks to Max, and you do with Solgar products that are 20% off. Again, the month of January at Max Medicine Mart in Kingsport. Tom Taylor Sports Show, thanks for being with us. Ben, are you a soccer fan? You like soccer? You follow it any?
Occasionally, not a whole lot.
All right. Starting in 2026, if we even want to be here in 2026, but if we are, the World Cup will be drastically different in soccer. The FIFA and FIFA Council have heard it pronounced both on a unanimous vote approving the expansion of 48 teams. And so they're going to go 16 groups to 3 teams each, the new format change. So if you're a soccer fan, from each group, 2 teams will advance to a 32-team knockout stage. That's coming up in 2026. Format modification is the first since the 98 World Cup, when it changed from 32 teams from 24. The 2026 World Cup, where we'll see the change, currently sees the United States as the favorite to host in 2026, which is, 9 years away. So get a little ahead of ourselves here, I think. But anyway, just if you're a soccer fan, that's going to be happening again starting in 2026. We're going to expand it to a 48-team field for the World Cup soccer in 2026. Also, in the PGA Tour coming up in golf this weekend, the Sony Open in Honolulu, Hawaii. What if they need somebody over there to carry their golf bags around and drive the golf cart? $6 million for the Sony Open. The Sony Open in Hawaii in Honolulu. And so the Sony Open, starting on the 12th, on Thursday through Sunday, again in Honolulu, with a $6 million purse on the PGA Tour. Of course, they'll start coming towards back in the 48 states a little bit later on in the early part of the year. In fact, later on in the month of January, they'll end up in California. AT&T Pebble Beach Pro-Am in February. Roll right into the Honda Classic in Florida in February. And, of course, roll right on down to the Masters in Augusta in early April. So, again, this week, the PGA Tour, the Sony Open in Hawaii. Tom Taylor Sports Show, thanks for being with us. We're going to do a little Georgia Brown coming up here in a few minutes. A little college basketball and high school basketball. Coming up again, I want to remind you, the drag racing schedule, Thunder Valley, is out for 2017. And so the Bristol Drag schedule featuring something for every type of drag racing fan, from the 17th annual NHRA Thunder Valley Nationals on Father's Day weekend to the new Fitzgerald Peterbilt Truck Show and fireworks. Thunder Valley hosting events offering a wide range of appeal. The 52nd season of Thunder Valley opens on Saturday, April the 1st, with street fights, allowing racing enthusiasts to tackle the quarter mile and street legal rides. We can take mine up there, take yours up here, Ben, and do a little street fights. That starts on April the 1st. I like to do that one time. Would you like to get up here and just floorboard and see what happens?
Yeah, I did it back when I was in the teens, and it's been years and years since I've been racing.
Yeah, so would that be something you'd want to take your vehicle up here and try and give it a whirl?
Yeah, I might do that. I take my motorcycle up there.
There you go. Can you race a motorcycle against a vehicle up there? It has to be bike against bike.
I have no idea.
I don't either. That'd be a good...
I guess we want to do a grudge match, we can do it.
There you go. There you go. Newest event on the calendar this year at Bristol Dragway is the Fitzgerald Peterbilt Truck Show and Fireworks running June 30th to July 1st. Also, the largest foot brake bracket races in the country, the World Foot Brake Challenge in July. Also, the NHRA Eastern Conference Finals in July. The Thompson Metal Monster Truck Madness presented by Beef O'Brady's in July. The Super Chevy Show in September at Bristol Dragway. All this can be found, again, by going to the website at bristoldragway.com. So, a big 2017 planned. It'll all get cranked up on April the 1st. We'll be giving away tickets to those events coming up, and so we're very excited about that as we get ready for spring racing at Bristol Motor Speedway. And, of course, the day opens up on April the 1st with our first big event, which will be Street Fights on Saturday, April the 1st. It's the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Thanks for being with us. We're live at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program. We're going to be joined next hour by Tim, our owner. He's going to stop by and visit with us here. We've got 4 minutes to the top of the hour. Also, another NFL story I forgot to tell you about. The Jacksonville Jags have hired Doug Marrone as their new head coach and brought back Tom Coughlin in the front office role. Marrone replaces Gus Bradley, who got fired in late November after going 14-48 in three seasons. The Jags also gave general manager Dave Caldwell a two-year contract extension. So one of the head coaching jobs has been determined and been filled, and that would be Doug Marrone, now the new football coach for the Jacksonville Jags in the National Football League. We'll take a quick break, come right back. We'll come back to the top of the hour and jump into basketball. Big night tonight at high school basketball. Run down the standings for you around the region and who's playing who. Also the NBA and college basketball. We'll let you know who's playing this week, who's taking on and tackling the Tennessee men's team, the ETSU men's team, the Lady Vols, the Lady Bucks, where they're going to be playing. All that and more in our basketball segment coming up next here at the top of the hour. Three before the hour, we're live at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program, and again, home of the Super Saver Maintenance Club. This card, again, for $99, it's a $519 value for only $99. You have 14 different points that you get. I'm going to say different points, but different points, not the right word. 14 different items, again, on the Super Saver Maintenance Club for only $99. If you bought it, came in and paid for all this, it cost you well over $500. You can get it for $99. Four oil changes, the two tire rotations, a complete car inspection, a free brake system inspection, free alignment. Free wiper blade with purchase of a wiper blade. Ben got that yesterday. $15 off transmission service. All this available, and again, it can be shared with multiple vehicles, and it's also good for 13 months. So buy it this month. It's good through February of 2018. And oh, by the way, it was rated the number one auto repair shop in America. In America by Federated Auto Parts. They went around and critiqued and analyzed and checked out over 4,000 auto repair shops in America. And the number one auto repair shop in the U.S. of A., so says Federated Auto Parts, would be these folks right here at American Import and Auto Repair between Johnson City and Jonesboro on West Market Street here in Johnson City. Their number is 913-3111. Quick break. We'll be right back. We'll take a look at basketball coming up next here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show, again on AM 790 and also on Facebook Live.
There you go. Yeah, you won.
I guess I won.
Yeah,
I guess I won.
Yeah, now you want it, so I got to get you the three tuned tones for 10. What kind of pizzas you like?
Cheese or whatever.
Just assorted, or you like, what do you not like on a pizza? Sausage, pepperoni?
Linda don't like pepperoni, so anything but the pepperoni.
Okay.
You're up, brother.
Ready round number two of the Top Thunder Sports Show. You're listening to AM 790 WETV, Johnson City, Kingsport, Bristol, live at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Free Loaner Car Program. Tomorrow, we're going to be on the road at Chick-fil-A. Thursday, we'll be at Champion Chevrolet. Then on Friday, our first stop at the new year at Food City. And our first Food City visit this year. We've got three this month coming up. We're going to be live at Food City in Jonesboro. We'll be at Dwayne's store, having a big time right down the road here in the oldest town in Tennessee. Sweet Georgia Brown time, college basketball, pro basketball. Yep. Here we go. Man, I love that.
We need to get that on your phone.
Yes, we do. Took the words right out of my mouth. You're exactly right. We need that on my phone. Love that. That is awesome. College basketball start there. Again, the polls are out this week. And the college basketball top 10, brand new number one for the men's side. The Baylor Bears are now number one. Villanova, having lost, drops down to number three. So here's your top 10. Baylor, Kansas, Villanova, UCLA, Gonzaga, Kentucky ranked sixth. Then comes Duke, Creighton, Florida State, and the West Virginia Mountaineers up three notches, or actually dropping three notches, down to number 10 this week. Two new teams in, Minnesota at number 24 and Kansas State at number 25 in the latest men's college basketball. Top five, Baylor, Kansas, Villanova, UCLA, and Gonzaga. For the ladies, UConn stays at number one. That's a shocker. UConn, Baylor, Maryland, Mississippi State, and South Carolina, the top five. Then comes the ladies from Notre Dame, Florida State, Washington, Louisville, and Oregon State to the top 10. The ladies from Virginia Tech, the Hokies, Lady Hokies, up three more than number 15 in the country. They're still undefeated at 15-0 in women's college basketball. Tonight, got some good ones. In fact, right out of the chute, West Virginia playing host to the Baylor Bears tonight in Morgan Hall. 7 o'clock tip-off. Again, Baylor number 1, West Virginia at number 10. That one will be at the Field House in Morgan Hall. I'm sorry, Morgantown, West Virginia. Us Marshall boys call it Morgan Hall. 15th-ranked Xavier. The Musketeers will be at number 3, Villanova tonight. 6th-ranked Kentucky on the road at Vanderbilt in Nashville. Also men's college hoops. 7th-ranked Duke will be at number 5, Florida State in Tallahassee tonight. Duke at 14-2, Florida State at 15-1. Let me go back up here. Baylor 15-0, number 1 in the country at West Virginia, number 10th-ranked, 13-2. Then you have Xavier, the Musketeers, 15th-ranked, 13-2, at Villanova, 15-1, 3rd-ranked in the country. Kentucky, 13-2, the Wildcats in Nashville to battle Vanderbilt at 8-7 tonight. 7th-ranked Duke, 14-2, with Jeff Cable, the substitute coach for the injured and out with surgery, Mike Shevsky. Duke, 7th-ranked, to be in Tallahassee to take on the Seminoles of Florida State, 15-1. That's an 8 o'clock tip-off tonight. Number 2, Kansas, the Jayhawks, 14-1, at Oklahoma, 6-8, trying to pull off the upset. And then 23rd-ranked Florida tonight, 12-3, the Gators in Tuscaloosa to battle Alabama, 9-5. In the Southeastern Conference, and again, the Gators 23rd ranked in the country. That's what's happening there in college basketball. Again, Tennessee plays tomorrow night against the South Carolina Gamecocks. They'll host them at Thompson Bowling Arena. Also, next up for the Buccaneers of East Tennessee State, they'll play Thursday at home against UNC Greensboro. The Lady Bucks will play again on Saturday on the road for Brittany Ezell's team in Chattanooga against the Lady Moccasins, and then the Lady Vols play on Thursday night. They'll be in Mississippi to battle the Ole Miss Lady Rebels. And that's your area teams as far as East Tennessee State and Tennessee as far as basketball there for those two teams, those two programs, or those two schools, rather. High school basketball polls are out this week. Here we go on the boys, AAA Memphis East, the number one in the state. Nobody from our region in AAA boys polls this week. In AA, Knox Catholic at number one. Elizabeth and the Cyclones are in as an honorable mention this week in AA. And in single A, Humboldt at number one. And again, no teams from our region in single A in the top 10 are honorable mention for the boys this week in boys basketball. Now for the ladies in AAA, Riverdale Murfreesboro Riverdale, number one to the state. Morristown West Lady Trojans, number nine. Daniel Boone's Lady Trailblazers ranked 10th in the state this week. Science Hill's Lady Hilltoppers in an honorable mention at AAA. In AA, it's Upperman at number one in the state. Buddy from our region is in AA. And in single A, Pickett County at number one. The South Green Lady Rebels in number two this week in the rankings in single A girls basketball from around the state of Tennessee. And then you have the schedule going on tonight. First off, on the boys' side, Science Hill, the top dog in the Big 7. They're going to be Science Hill hosting Crockett tonight, a little backyard rivalry. Science Hill number one, Crockett number two in the Big 7, playing each other tonight at the Topper Gym on the campus of Science Hill tonight. Dobbins Vinter will be at Daniel Boone, Tennessee High at Sullivan Central. Unicoi County and Elizabethan will be in a buzz bomb tonight in Elizabethan. Sullivan South at Johnson County, Sullivan East at Sullivan North. North Green will be in Johnson City to play University High. The Hampton Bulls hosting Cloudland and Unaked South Green. All these games, I assume, are on, even though school's out in a lot of the counties around the region. So, Big 7 Conference, Science Hill 1, Crockett 2. In the Three Rivers, Elizabethan number 1, Sullivan East at number 2, and Happy Valley and Unicoi County tied for 3rd. In the Watauga Valley Conference, the guys, Hampton number 1, Cloudland and Hampton both are tied at 2-0. North Green and South Green are in 2nd place, each with a record of 1-1. Now for the girls, Big 7 Conference, Daniel Boone on top, Science Hill in 2nd place. Three Rivers Conference, Lady Cyclones of Elizabethan at 3-0, Sullivan East at 2-0, and Happy Valley in 3rd right now for the Lady Warriors. And in the Watauga Valley Conference, Cloudland and Hampton are number 1. South Green currently 2nd in the Watauga Valley Conference, even though South Green's ranked in the state. Cloudland and Hampton are not, which is interesting. Watauga Valley Conference for the ladies. Cloudland and Hampton are not ranked, and South Green is, and they're 3rd in the conference. So, go figure. That's an interesting analysis. Also, from yesterday, talking about basketball, it was Milligan winning their 3rd in the row for the guys, at career-high 27 points for Alex Bickerstaff, as Milligan beats Point 94-86 at Lacey Fieldhouse at Milligan. They're now 9-8, having won 3rd in a row, 3 in a row, 9-8 overall, 6-4 in the AAC. Tyler Nichols from Elizabethan added 14 points for the Buffaloes. On the other side of the ledger, the Lady Buffaloes losing last night, 61-57. Lindsey Price, 15 for Milligan on losing calls. And also Mackenzie Razor had 13 in losing calls on the 23rd-ranked Milligan College women's basketball, coming up short against Point University last night, 61-57. That's a look at college basketball, high school basketball. What about the NBA? Let's run those down for you from yesterday and last night. Goes as follows. The Pelicans over the Knicks, 110-96. Timberwolves beat the Mavericks by 9 last night. And the Bulls and the Thunder, Oklahoma City beat Chicago, 109-94, beat them by 15. Tonight, it looks like this. The Bulls, Chicago in Washington, the Celtics in Toronto. Atlanta will take on the Nets in Brooklyn. The Rockets home to the Hornets tonight. And my boys, the San Antonio Spurs, hosting the Milwaukee Bucks tonight in San Antonio. Also tonight, the world champion Cavaliers in Utah to battle the Jazz. The Miami Heat will be in Golden State to take on the Warriors. Portland will take on the Lakers in Los Angeles. And the Detroit Pistons will be taking on Sacramento, the Kings in Sacramento. Right now in the NBA, the top 5 teams in the National Basketball Association, record-wise, Golden State, San Antonio, Cleveland, Houston, and Toronto, the top 5 in the NBA right now. And so pro basketball are ready to go tonight in a big-time night, and also college basketball and high school. I have all that for you tomorrow. On Wednesday, we will be live at Chick-fil-A at the Crossings in North Johnson City on Wednesday. We'll take a quick break. Come right back. He's here. Our buddy Bob from Book Lovers Warehouse in Johnson City is going to join us coming up next year. We're live on the road, American Import and Auto Repair. Tomorrow will be at Chick-fil-A. Thursday will be at Champion Chevrolet. Friday will be at Food City in Jonesboro. And so we just keep on keeping on, taking out on the road. We got a feature show coming up at Freddy's, the new hamburger stand, if you will, at Freddy's restaurant here in North Johnson City. We're also going to be working out a stop at Rick Hill Imports and Kingsport, so Max Medicine Martin Kingsport, so we're all over the place. Bob from Book Lovers Warehouse joins us coming up next year. We're live at American Import and Auto Repair on the Tom Taylor Sports Show on AM 790 WETB and also on Facebook Live. Oh, excuse me.
Did you read that article?
I'm going to, yeah. He's going to. Why?
I don't know. Just sort of coming out. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah. kind of a breaking news thing.
Is this a joke?
I promise you. Oh, really? I wouldn't tell you to put it on the air if it was.
Oh.
I wouldn't do that, dude. Now, after you're done, I might joke with you.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. No. So this legitimate Carl Edwards is retiring immediately?
You know who J-Ski is?
Yeah.
It was on J-Ski. That's
it. It's on J-Ski. It's true. I mean, that's pretty reliable.
Yeah. So,
you're not bumming. I've just been trying to get people up there.
So, I just thought you might want to see that. Can you believe that? It's hard to believe.
Wow.
Carl Edwards is retiring?
Yeah.
That doesn't sound right.
How you doing?
Oh, not bad.
Yep. Can you hear him loud and clear, Ben?
I'm Bob Coletta.
Nice to meet you. Somebody texted in and said...
Can't hear him? Okay.
Somebody texted us and said you need to turn the visitor's mic up.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Somebody texted you and said turn the visitor's mic up?
Texted on there. On the Google
feedback. It was Mr. Foy, I think.
Oh, it was Ben. Did you text down here and tell him to turn the sound up? Ben? Okay. Yeah, it was Ben. Good. Can you hear Bob
now? Can you hear me now?
Can you hear him now? Okay. All right. All right. Me or him? Either one of you.
I hear one.
There you go. Thank you. Oh, let's set our timer here. What's our timer? Set it for 47. Back with the Tom Taylor Sports Show. We're live again at American Import Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program. We're joined by our buddy Bob Coletta. Good afternoon, sir. How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing good. I forgot this is a sports show. I'm a bookstore owner, and ironically enough, I do books online, and I sold 3 golf books today online. So evidently, this weather's not bothering people when they want to go out and play golf.
Yeah, we were talking about Book Lovers Warehouse again. It's a 6,000 square foot bookstore right up the road here in Johnson City, right beside Harbor Freight Tools. And again, if you're looking for used books, if you're looking for all these different categories of used books, DVDs, VHS tapes, CDs, you got them all. And so, let's talk. When I was in there looking at the sports section, you've got, these are hardback books of Tim Tebow, the late Arnold Palmer. You've got NFL. You've got college football books. These are hardbacks that generally retail for how much?
Oh, $20 to $40 each, and the ours are probably $4 to $5.
Yeah, absolutely. $4.99. I saw the big hardback book of Tim Tebow. $4.99. Again, Arnold Palmer, you've got how-to books in there about bowling, how to improve bowling, how to do weightlifting, weight training. You sold some books online about golf.
Yeah, so, we sell a lot of golf books, and we sell a lot of books about tennis, too. So, I don't know, people playing out on these icy courts, whatever. We've got an amazing amount of sports books.
Let's talk the trade again. We're talking about Book Lovers Warehouse here in Johnson City. We're broadcasting live at American Import and Auto Repair. Tell us about the trade. You take in a lot of trade.
Well, the fact that we got, 200,000 or 300,000 books means that we take in probably 95% of it in trade. So if you have something interesting, unusual, not common, or we'll give you a credit and you can use it anywhere in the store, we get probably 20 to 40 people a day bringing in books. So, and we take more than anybody else. So bring in your books, see what you can do, and take out what you need.
The holidays are behind us. What were big sellers? What types of books do folks come in looking for the holidays?
Well, they're looking for something that their mother, father, brothers, sisters read. The biggest selling book probably is mystery and romance. But we have a great collection of sci-fi and fantasy books. So if you're interested in escape and murder mysteries, 10 years ago, one of the biggest sellers in the store was true crime. But right now, it's real crime.
Exactly right. So let's talk Civil War. It's a big area around here, Civil War. Tell me about that.
Well, I've got a nice section of Civil War. I had a man pass away about 3 years ago, and the executor brought in almost 100 boxes of Civil War books. And we've sold probably most of them, but we still have, a couple thousand left of Civil War. So we've got a nice selection of Civil War books, and before then we never got any hardly at all. So bring in your Civil War books, because this is a big section of Civil War, and people don't realize how much went on during the Civil War right around this area.
Absolutely. And of course, sports, you got a great selection of NASCAR books. Tell me about that.
That's another thing. We had a wholesaler go out of business 3 or 4 years ago, and we ended up with a lot of NASCAR. All the best drivers, all the best, all kinds of NASCAR competitions. If you're a NASCAR fan, you should come by and see what we have, because if you like this stuff, we have a lot of NASCAR books in there for you to peruse through and see if you have or not have. But once when we got them, we sold a lot of them. We're still selling them on a regular basis, but. I've got a great selection of them.
47 days to the Daytona 500, by the way. It's a great time to be talking NASCAR. We're getting ready to get geared up for the Bristol Motor Speedway racing season in April with the Food City 500, the 25th anniversary. The second longest running sponsor in NASCAR as far as a race sponsor behind only Coca-Cola is Food City, and their 25th anniversary of racing at Bristol Motor Speedway. And they've got a lot of things planned this year for that, so we'll tell you more about that as we get a little bit closer to racing season at Bristol Speedway. We're talking to Bob from Book Lovers Warehouse. We're live here at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program here in Johnson City. Coming up at the top of the hour, we'll turn things over to Charles Stanley and the In Touch program. Bob, back in the inspirational / religious section, you have a lot of Charles Stanley books, don't you?
We do have a lot of Charles Stanley books. As a matter of fact, I sold one Charles Stanley book. I don't remember the specific title of it. He's a big seller. His television show draws a couple million people every week. So if you love to listen to him, get some of his books. I think he's written 20 different books over the last 20 years. So Charles Stanley is a good selling author. So come on and see. Let me point out, though, we also have Christian fiction and Christian romance. So if you like a romance book or a fiction book with Christian basics in it, stop by, because that's probably our fourth biggest seller in the store is Christian fiction.
6,000 square feet store, again, it's in between John City and Jonesboro, right beside Harbor Freight Tools. And again, before I let you go, gift certificates, another good reason to come in there. Anytime's a good time to give a gift certificate. Valentine's Day is the next holiday coming up, so that's a good way to give someone you love a chance to come in and shop at Book Lovers Warehouse. And tell us about the gift certificates.
Have gift certificates to purchase in the store, and there's something we do every year in December. I'm going to go ahead and start doing it year round. If you brought in books for trade, and you have like $50 worth of trade, convert it to gift certificates and give them as gifts for people's birthday and Valentine's Day and Christmas. That way, we'll get a new customer in, hopefully, and you'll get to give someone something they'll really enjoy, because they can come.
There you go. It's a great place to shop. Love going in there. And again, CDs, DVDs, VHS. If you're looking for VHS tapes, I bet you got what? A couple thousand VHS tapes?
We do. We have VHS has come back because there's a lot of movies on VHS that's not on DVD and is not in your download history. So if you can find a VHS and you have the ability to convert it with your computer, you can put it in your system, and you'll have a movie you can't get anywhere else. So come and see what we have in the DVDs. All the classics you've ever heard of in the last 3 or 4 years.
There you go. I appreciate you being here, my friend. As always, great job, and we'll talk to you soon, all right? Yep. Great job, everybody. Bob from Book Lovers Warehouse here again on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. We're live again at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program, again on this Tuesday, January the 10th. And again, we are looking at 47 days to the Daytona 500. We got some breaking NASCAR news. It would appear Carl Edwards. I'm sorry?
Have you got it? I've got it right here in front of
you. Yeah, Carl Edwards to retire immediately. Carl Edwards expected to announce tomorrow that he will retire immediately from NASCAR racing. Edwards, 37 years old, spent 13 years in the Cup Series, won 28 times and 445 starts. No immediate reason was available for why Edwards would retire. Daniel Suarez will be named his replacement in the number 19. Suarez from Mexico became the first foreign-born driver to win a NASCAR National Series when he won the Xfinity Series title last season. Joe Gibbs Racing is scheduled to hold two separate news conferences tomorrow, starting at 10 o'clock. Again, from its headquarters in Huntersville, one of those is the retirement of Carl Edwards. The other would be the contract extension for Denny Hamlin. Edwards leaving Joe Gibbs Racing to pursue other interests outside of driving and will not compete in 2017. I don't know if it's a health issue. I'm sure we'll be told over the next day or so, but Carl Edwards apparently walking away from the sport immediately. This guy was in the chase, of course, and not, and spent 13 years in the Cup Series, won 28 times, and so... Carl Edwards, again, looks like he's going to step away from, or is stepping away, not only from Joe Gibbs Racing, but from racing in general to pursue other interests, which Ben Foy, obviously in the NASCAR circles, this is a huge, huge development and going on with Carl Edwards. What's your take on it?
Something's going on somewhere for them to wait till the last minute before the season starts to announce this. I would think, I mean, you just don't normally see this. Of course, now, one thing about Carl Edwards, he is very low profile on his personal life. He's not even on Twitter, I don't think, and keeps pretty low profile about his personal life and all like that. So you don't really get a whole lot of the inside stuff like a lot of the other drivers that put everything out there.
Yep, so Carl Edwards expect to announce tomorrow that he will retire immediately from NASCAR racing, and... Yeah, wonder why. You get through Christmas and you're gearing up. Everybody's getting ready to go down and start testing. The Daytona 500, 47 days out. I mean, now's a very, very busy time for all the drivers. And so, wonder what, you know, what made this happen and what kind of pushed the point to get him to do it.
I don't think the play is nothing medical. You know, I hope it's a decision he makes without having to force it in any other way.
Yep, I'm with you. So, I don't know what made it happen. And what the timing is interesting to say the least. But, again... Breaking sports news, Carl Edwards stepping away from NASCAR immediately. Daniel Suarez will be the new driver for the number 19 for Joe Gibbs Racing. Denny Hamlin will get a contract extension to continue to drive for Joe Gibbs, and so all that's coming up. And we will obviously delve into that in length tomorrow on the show. We'll be live at Chick-fil-A, and I'm sure between now and then there'll be lots to will be coming out about that. The press conference will be tomorrow to, again, make it official. Also, Edwards leaving to pursue other interests outside of driving will not compete in 2017. Would that be television? I wonder what it would be to get him to walk away from making major, major money for Joe Gibbs Racing.
I have no idea, but like I say, I just hope it's nothing medical or anything like that. I don't think it's the decision he's making because of what he wants to do, not what he has to do.
There you go. I'm right there with you. So... Anyway, that's the very latest. We appreciate both Ben on that end and Tim bringing it in here a few minutes ago. We're going to talk to Tim coming up here in a second. So, again, Carl Edwards stepping away from NASCAR, effective immediately. That announcement to be made official tomorrow outside of Charlotte in their at the Joe Gibbs Racing camp, if you will, in Huntersville, North Carolina. Happy New Year, and thank you for all of us at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile for a great 2016. They moved a record 200 vehicles in the month of December. They began, that's unbelievable, 163 new Chevrolets or Cadillacs or both went off the lot at Champion Chevrolet in the month of December alone. 163 new cars. And whatever the difference is, what is that, 27, is that right, 27, 37? I guess it'd be 37 used vehicles as well. So they got a huge used car selection right now at Champion Chevrolet as a result of that. Over 200 brand new Silverados to choose from with all-star crew and double cabs, $10,000 off MSRP. That's stock number 6769. They've got a Camaro there, if it's still there. This he gave this to me last week. We'll be there on Thursday. They had a 2017 Camaro for $23,440, stock number 6898. They had a 2017 Equinox 21.9, stock number 6278. You can shop them online, and don't forget their Saturday service. service hours at Champion Chevrolet. We will be there on Thursday, broadcasted live. And again, they have over 450 new Chevrolets to choose from. Good grief. Over. How do they do that? You got that right. 450 new Chevys to choose from and over 200 Silverados to choose from. A Champion Chevrolet. Again, they moved 200 vehicles in the month of December. Champion Chevrolet. That is flat, running them out the door. No question about that. We'll take a break. We'll come right back. Tim's going to join us. We're live here at Champion Chevrolet. Where we're going to be on Thursday. Tomorrow will be at Chick-fil-A. We're live here at American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Free Loaner Car Program, the number one auto repair shop in America. So says Federated Auto Parts for 2016. And we'll come back with more from American Import and Auto Repair right after this time out on the Tom Taylor Sports Show on AM 790 WETB and also on Facebook Live.
Do you want Tim?
Yes, ma'am, please.
Which Chick-fil-A did you go to?
Across from Home Depot.
Oh, really?
Yeah, come up here for lunch.
Okay.
Huh? You'll buy you lunch. If you come up here, you get free lunch.
Uh-huh.
There you go. Why would you not?
Exactly.
If it's free, why would you not? All you got to do is come in and wave and smile, and you don't have to sit there and eat and get it to go.
Yeah, that's all Fox Sports, too. As a matter of fact,
yeah.
Tom gives that story.
Yeah.
Jason got it from Fox.
I just hope it's not medical. But
I do, too. But I understand
it
being frustrated. I understand that too, you know.
Oh, yeah.
So close.
Let's set this timer here real quick while I'm thinking about it, please.
All right.
How many minutes?
12:25 right now.
All right. So that'd be 35.
It's 12:27. I'm sorry, 12:27.
It
was 32 minutes.
I set it at 32 right now, so that'll
be good.
Did you get Mr. Smith?
I told him, he said he's up here in an hour. I go, where was he? But I said, well, he said he'll be up here in a minute.
Okay. Hello, Facebook Live folks. Again, TomTaylorSports.com. Again, we're juggling radio and Facebook at the same time. We will have, in the very near future, talked to some folks about that just this morning, about being able to have radio and the Facebook kind of together. So interfaced, if you will, so you'll be able to hear both at the same time. That's what we're working on. So, but thank you again for liking us and sharing us. Again, just go to TomTaylorSports.com. Everything is right there. We need to check it out.
You're up.
And we appreciate that very, very much. Back on the Tom Taylor Sports Show, again, that breaking story. I continue to scratch my head on that one, on Carl Edwards stepping away from NASCAR. It's either going to be one of two things. There's a television opportunity. This is purely speculation. Or there's a health issue. I hope it's A and not B. But for him to walk away, I mean, the guy's, 37 years old? So it's not like, I mean, he's not a youngster, but like a Chase Elliott or a Ryan Blaney, but still got some gas in the tank, if you will, to be driving 13 years in the Cup Series, 28 victories. And so it's either got up to me, and again, I'm just off the top of my head, this is just breaking news. I'm talking either a medical situation, we hope is not the case, or, you know, pursuing other interests, maybe on television. You know, going to go into broadcast because he's very articulate. He's very funny. He would be a great commentator in NASCAR. Problem that is, Ben, it's getting filled up. Junior wants to do it. Kevin Harvick's talking about doing some of it now, and he retires. Jeff Gordon's doing it. So Waltrip's already doing it, Michael Waltrip. So the opportunities to be in the broadcast booth are beginning. I mean, there's more folks wanting to do it, and there are spots to do it, I believe. What do you think?
He's seen how long he's been the past few years.
Well, Tim's here with us. Good afternoon, sir. How you doing?
Good.
Good. Can you hear him loud and clear, I hope? Is he good? Got the ball zone good and loud. You're exactly right. So, what I'm thinking is, going back, this is off the top of my head. Now's, you know, you get through the holidays, now you're getting ready to gear up. All the promotional things you got to do and everything, you're getting ready to go testing. You know, he may have just said, we'll know tomorrow, but he may have just said, you know, I don't want to do it anymore. I've lost the burn. I hope that's it. I just hope it's not medical, because...
What if it's another thing? F1 or something like that?
Could be. It could be driving another series. That's exactly right. But for him just to... I just think the timing's interesting. Here it is, early January, and, you know, I would have thought... Yeah. Now you're supposed to be getting revved up and ready to go, and you're 47 days away from the Daytona 500, and, you know, as I said, now's when they're doing all the commercials and the promotional appearances, and... And they got their uniforms on, taking the pictures and doing all the... He's a huge name. 28 wins in his career. I mean, this guy's top 25 all-time wins, so...
His uncle is a trader, right? Contrader?
Yeah, I think... No, is it kid... No?
I think it is. And his... when he first started out, Roush was going to give him a contract. And he called his uncle up and said... I always remember the story because I thought it was really funny. And he asked Schrader, what should I do? He says, well, I want you to come and look at the contract to make sure everything's good with it. He says, well, do you have any other contracts there? And he said, no. He said, then sign that one.
There you go. Do you have any other options? No, then sign that one, go. So Ken Schrader's his uncle. I did not know that.
I think so.
Wow, I learned something new. So anyway, big story breaking. Also tomorrow they're going to announce a contract extension for Denny Hamlin, which is, you know, keeps him in a FedEx Toyota for some few more years. Bush is already nailed down, and so, you know, you got Kenseth is probably the oldest of the bunch, and, you know, he's starting to wind things down a little bit, but he's back again this year. So
happy to hear him say I'm going to retire.
Exactly.
A little bit more bleak.
Yeah, I can understand that one.
Yeah.
I don't understand a 37-year-old guy with 28 wins and lots of...
if you were making like...
I'm out. I'm gone. I'm gonna come back.
Maybe that's what he did.
Yeah, I'm out. I'm hanging with my wife, my kids. I'm gonna come and hang out with Tim. We're gonna go to Cracker Barrel and eat. We're gonna go to Chick-fil-A. We're gonna do somewhere. So we're gonna go fishing. You like to fish, by the way?
Yeah, if there's fish out there, most of the time they hide from me.
So you don't like fishing?
I like it if I can catch them.
There you go. So
they hide.
$10 million a year he's making, so yeah, he's there's got to be something to it. Again, I just hope, as I said, being redundant, it's not medical.
It's medical. I mean, he's doing backflips off the cars when he wins. He's in good shape. I mean, if you look at him, he's probably one of, can you name anybody that's in better shape than him?
He's an avid workout enthusiast, and I know when he comes to Bristol, he always goes, you know, they kind of run him over there to the place where he can work out by himself and the workout facility. So, yeah, this guy's a workout machine. But just there's interesting.
Other opportunities.
Very interesting. Hey, tell me about this Super Saver Maintenance Club card. We're going to get into the National Football League and talk about Kim Steelers. She was up a while ago and said, how about them Steelers? She said, how about them Steelers? Oh, yeah, she's a happy camper. Yeah, she should be. They're one of the hottest teams in the National Football League. We'll get into that. Super Saver Maintenance Club. Tell me about it.
The reason they're hot is because the Dolphins. The Dolphins beat them and got them started. Any good that they're doing now is because of that.
Dolphins stirred them up, made them mad. I got you.
Stirred up a Hornets nest.
Right.
Super Saver. We want to help you budget your money throughout the year. You buy this now. You get 13 months with it. Wife, kids, whoever wants to get oil changes, you hand them this card, they come down here and they walk out of here for this. There's all kinds of other stuff on here, you know, other maintenance, transmission service, AC service. Probably not need an AC service this week, but you never know.
It really does. It's going to be in the 60s. You never know.
Toward the end of the week. So, quite a bit of stuff on here. You got alignment, you got all kinds of stuff. So, good maintenance plan. We want you to take care of your cars, and if you take care of them and maintain them, you don't have the oops in the repair in there.
We're talking to our buddy Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Free Loan Car Program. Again, we are live at his store right here, his shop. We don't talk much about this, but you guys do a lot of commercial and fleet people.
Yes, we do.
Talk about that.
Well, if you have any kind of fleet at all, we would be happy to help you out. We anything from some of the smaller plumbing companies all the way up into 200 vehicle fleets. We take care of them pretty regularly. If you come by here, you'll actually see them. Some out front, some out back. We try to get them in and out from their oil changes quickly because we know their guys need it to get to the next appointment and to make money and to do stuff for people. So we take care of that for them and keep them on the road.
We had Scott on earlier and Misty. Scott talking about the AC batteries. You have replaced a lot of batteries this week, haven't you?
Quite a few batteries. We have a big selection of them. So run them in and run them out.
American made, by the way. American made. You got it. Now, on the door, the ASC blue seal of excellence. What's that all about?
Some people have taken a few ASC tests and they said, you know, we're ASC certified and everything like that. If you're an ASC master tech, that means you've taken 8 big tests and passed them all. And sometimes you can do that with, we have 3 ASC master technicians. So, the blue seal means that the majority of our guys have passed all those tests and they are ready to go. We want them to keep updated because cars change every year and they want to keep updated. You know, if you're doing a car 20 years ago, it's a lot different than if you're doing a car now. So we try to stay updated on everything, keep the computers and everything going. You know, like with Microsoft, you can update, you know, at night they'll update the computers and this and that. The computers in your car also will update. And we can do that. Take care of
you. Dr. Jim Smith, the owner of American Import and Auto Repair, we're here for 22 more minutes. We'll turn things over to Charles Stanley. Back to Carl Edwards again, stepping away from the sport, effective immediately. Daniel Soares, young man who, of course, he is... Yeah, he's from Tampa. Daniel Soares is from Soares from Mexico. Became the first foreign, what's go to Tampa and hang a real sharp left. Became the first foreign-born driver to win a national series when he earned the Xfinity Series title this year, 2016. So Joe Gibbs says this guy, you know, by default looks like he's ready to roll. So they're gonna put him in the 19 ride and turn him loose. So
somebody comes in and tells you I'm retiring, you hope that you have somebody in line for you.
Yep.
Do you think they'd be a better choice for that? Who was the other guy that they just loaned out to the other Toyota place? Daniel Suarez and Eric.
Oh, Eric Jones. Eric Jones, yeah.
If you were Gibbs, which one would you be?
Suarez won the title. So, and from NASCAR standpoint, it's an ideal storm because he is attracting the Hispanic base big time.
Yes.
Where they're more, where there's more of them in the population base down in the southwestern part of the country. Getting a lot of folks down there following him because of being from Mexico. So, from NASCAR, from a PR standpoint, it's great, but the guy can drive a car because he won the Xfinity Series. So, I'm sure that Joe didn't want to do it under these conditions to say, tap him on the shoulder and say, you're the man. So, but yeah, Eric Jones definitely won. And then, of course, you still got Kyle Busch and Matt Kenseth and Denny Hamlin in the fold, so. Kyle Busch. No question.
Who's a lackey? There's no lackey in there, but who would you say could easily boost?
Probably Soares now. I mean, the other three guys, I'd say, gosh, how do you argue? That's a great question.
Yeah.
Maybe Denny Hamlin.
Yeah. Yeah, because he's been out of a long time, and he flirts with the idea of doing it, but he just never brings it home.
Yeah, Kenseth, obviously, as he is by virtue of being a champion.
Yeah.
Busch is a champion. I would say out of those three, the I don't guess he's the worst of the three, but the one that out of the three, I would be Denny Hamlin.
Yeah, and they just signed him to him.
They're going to have a news conference about that tomorrow as well. So this will be happening at 10 o'clock, so we'll be able to give you some
updates
right out of the chute. Yep, 11 o'clock when we go in there. And so Looking forward to that. We're live here again, American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program. Federated Auto Parts, named to the number one in the country. Now, do they come back again and we go through the process again, or is it a one-time shot?
It would be kind of tough to do it.
I mean,
4,000 other shops are looking to do that, so I don't think we could do it.
But are you going to try and defend your crown and go through the process, or it's a one-shot deal?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
To be selfish. And, other people need a shot too.
Yeah. So, one's good. One time's good. That's it. Good turn, that boy. This is smooth. Ben, did you see? Did you hear that? That means he didn't want to talk about it anymore. We went to a football game. Yes. Yeah, it's funny how that worked. Just kind of went on a rabbit trail. Yes, it was a football game last night. And you, what did you watch it?
I watched some of it, and I assumed it was going to go one way, but it didn't go that.
No.
Did you watch it all?
To blame the quarterback for Alabama because they got beat, ridiculous. I mean, Alabama's defense let them down.
Yeah, they marched down the field right at the end.
And Deshaun Watson, again, I go back to on a big stage, big game, the big-time players step up. Aaron Rodgers did it Sunday. Ben Roethlisberger did it Sunday. Odell Beckham Jr. did not do it on Sunday for the Giants. And Deshaun Watson did it. The guy in the second half was 23 out of 34 in the second half. Some guys don't do that for a whole game. He was 36 out of 56 for 420 yards and 3 touchdowns.
I read an article about him. Do you know what kind of house he grew up?
Not much of one.
Warwick
Dunn. Warwick Dunn, former Florida State player who, when he made a lot of money in the National Football League, went out and bought houses for underprivileged families. And
53 so far.
Yeah. And Deshaun Watson was one of the guys that he bought a house for.
He was a little tyke.
Little guy. Oh, yeah. So that's pretty classy there.
That really is.
So, and what's sad is we don't hear enough about the Warwick Dunn of the world.
I agree.
We hear about Odell Beckham banging his head against the wall and punching a hole in the sheet box.
Who cares about that?
Who cares?
This is something that 153 houses that somebody has actually done and using his fame to actually help the community.
Yeah, make it a better place.
He is.
Yeah. So Warwick Dunn, if you don't played at Florida State and play in the National Football League, had a great career.
Tampa Bay?
Mm-hmm. With the Buccaneers, and again, has gone back and built houses for kids, and one of them over the years was Deshaun Watson and his mom and his family. So,
he said he owes a lot to him.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. No telling where he didn't have that house. So,
homeless?
The new house. The what?
Okay. He said no telling where he would be unless he had that house, and I said homeless.
Yeah, you're right. He's been homeless. Yeah. Okay. I know there's a reason why I come down here as often as I do, because I love coming down here. But yeah, you're right. So back to the game. Yes, there was a game. Clemson's offense was, Watson puts up 811 yards in two games against Alabama's defense. I mean, there it is. It's not, can't put it off on the quarterback. You put it back on Alabama's defense, notably their pass defense. And the guy had threw to six different receivers. 420 yards passing. Oh, he's all over the field.
Yeah.
The defense, Alabama ran 66 plays in the game. Clemson ran 99 plays. So if you run 33 more plays than more than I do, and I'm still in the football game, that's pretty phenomenal.
Yeah.
Yeah. But for Alabama to even hang around and be in the game,
yeah.
You run 33 more plays than I have.
Do you think they were the winners?
Which one?
Alabama.
Yes, I thought Alabama was going to win. So, and they were in position to do it. Went right down the field, scored, and then, but Clemson, it was just meant to be, and came roaring right back down the field. So, pretty impressive.
And he declared for the.
Yeah, he's gone. Watson's leaving, so a lot of them leaving. So, they're leaving. They're going out on top. So.
Yeah. Well, after a performance like that, what else can you do?
Yeah, you can't top that.
No.
And you can't top that game. And as good as last year's was, 45-40 last night's was better. You're down to the final play, down to the final second of the game. You throw a touchdown to win it. I mean, that's like. Where you sit at home when your kid will look up in the ceiling as a little boy in the bedroom and dream of those kind of nights. So.
And the TV, you got to be happy with that. Too.
Oh, absolutely. Great rating. Except, yeah. My beef is, why start at 8:30? Because the game ended, 12:30, somewhere through there last night. It was late. It's after midnight. Huh? I had my curlers in. So I had my mud pack on. I still washed it. Had my curlers in. My George Foreman curlers. So, there you go. It's all right. So
you wanted to start earlier, what, about 4:30 or 5?
Yeah, 7:30. What's wrong with 7:30? Why 8:30?
Wheel of Fortune's on?
Yeah. I mean, you finish 7:30, you finish an hour earlier, you're done before midnight, folks. I mean, you know, some of us have to work for a living. I know schools are out, so the kids can stay on and watch it, but when they set the time, they didn't realize we're going to have a snow delay in Northeast Tennessee. So, but I just think, you know, that kind of game and that kind of importance, let everybody be able to see it and start a little bit earlier. I mean, yes, sir?
7:30 is 4:30
on the West Coast. That's why. I'm not on the West Coast. I'm on the East Coast. Oh, well, they need to take off early.
Tom has his bedtime.
We're over here. We drive the bus on the East Coast, not over there over there where they are. So, but anyway, it is what it is. Bottom line is a great football game, yeah.
Yeah.
What are the hours you're open here? At
8 to 5 on Friday, 8 to 12.
There you go. Are you okay? Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Everything good? Yeah, I'm doing great. So.
You look very nice over there.
Thank you. You look dainty too. And may I say,
Where's your Raiders hat?
It's not here. It's not with me today. Now, we got Patrick and Michael, our oral techs. Thanks to Misty, wrote this down for me. Misty, Blaine, and Scott in here in the office. Our techs are Kent and Jake and Greg and Stevie.
And Tom.
And the owners are Kim and Tim. So,
and Tom.
And Tom. Thank you. Which one am I? My tech?
You're here today, so you're
I'm a tech. I'm part of the oil tech team. No, actually, I'm part of the office staff. So, I'm media relations. Yeah, Misty, Blaine, Scott, and Tom. There you go.
Yeah.
It sounds like it's got a winning.
Terrible Tom.
There you go. All right, let me get your picks before we get out of here. Seattle, Atlanta on Saturday. What do you think?
I already said Atlanta.
I know you said it, but you can change. I know we did this yesterday, but you can have a mood swing.
I stopped you, so.
Yeah. Trust me, he can have a mood swing, so you can change. Is it Seattle or Atlanta?
Atlanta.
Houston, New England. Foxborough.
That's easy.
Patriots.
Of course.
Sunday, Kim's Steelers in Kansas. Let me go ahead and finish that one for you. At the Smith House, Tom, we'll be cheering for the Steelers. Gotcha. At Kansas City. And I understand that loud and clear. Packers in Dallas.
Packers.
Ooh, that's going to be tough, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's going to be really tough.
I talked to a lady the other day. She said, if I could have one wish, I could to run my fingers through Clay Matthews' hair. I said, really? She said, to grab his bicep one time and run my hands through his hair. She said, then I could die.
I'd like to touch any of them.
You what?
I'd like to run my hair through me, or my hands through any.
There you go. So, Packers or Cowboys?
I would say Green Bay.
Thank you, Tim. I love you.
Really? In Dallas? Wow. Yeah. I've been upset.
You know. They're hot. I mean,
okay.
Aaron Rodgers is doing everything right.
Yeah. Said he's going to run the table, and they did.
And Dak Prescott is a rookie.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm thinking.
There you go. You're thinking Packers.
Yeah. What are you thinking?
Raiders, baby.
You want to do the Super?
No, seriously. I don't, which one do you think?
Oh, you want me to make a pick?
Yeah.
I'm taking the Steelers, Green Bay, Dallas.
It's a tough one.
Packers are red hot, and Rodgers is. Rodgers is fearless.
When he's on.
And by the way, Jordy Nelson looks like he's going to play.
With broken ribs.
He says he's going to play with his broken ribs. They're going to set him out for practice these 2 days, and they think he can play on Sunday, which is huge. Yeah. Big Christian guy, too. Yeah. Big devoted FCA guy. Seattle, Atlanta, taking the Falcons. And then, so I got Atlanta, New England, Steelers, and Green Bay. Although, I'm pulling for Jason Witten because he's such a class.
He is.
So I like to see him get a ring. I like to see him get a ring because he is such a good guy. Talking about a guy that does good things nobody knows about. Some things I heard about he did over the Christmas here in the Tri-Cities that nobody knows about, that he really does good stuff. So, oh, yeah. So instead of hearing about Odell Beckham, guy asked me yesterday, listening to him, he said, do you really think that's unusual behavior? I said, a grown man to go up to the sheetrock and bang his head against the wall? That's not normal behavior. Is that where you came from? Is that not? Well, maybe.
That's odd.
It is odd. And then turn around and punch a hole in the wall. Really?
Yeah. I'll give you $10 if you do it here. I'll put it online.
Put it on $8. I'm jacking it up, busting it. You don't have to go $10. Give me $8 and another Dr. Nub, and I'll do it. You got $8?
I have $8.
Okay. I can flat wear it out right now. Just put some money.
It's like your brother when you were 10.
You think I'm kidding you? I can turn right around and I can put a hole right there, but I won't. So, Tim, thanks for letting me come down here. It's awesome.
Didn't your brothers and you used to get into it a lot when you were a kid?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he called me out about 10 years ago. We had to go out in the yard and settle a few things. So
in West Virginia?
Oh, yeah. Thanksgiving dinner. Thanksgiving dinner, right there in the yard. Said, I need to see you outside. I said, okay, what's up? Do you remember the time, dot, dot, dot? He said, I don't like that. And so we went ahead and resolved it again. So
did they get EMS out there before? So
he didn't like the first time. He didn't like the second time either. He didn't like what he got. So, but he had to come in and sit down. He had a lot of missed buttons on his shirt. He finished his Thanksgiving dinner with missing buttons on his shirt. And a pump dial in his head. I'll call him out. Jack, anytime you want some of this, call me. I'm up the interstate. I'm there. There you go.
Where is he at now?
I don't know.
What city?
I have no clue.
I don't know what city.
He's in West Virginia somewhere, yeah. So he's a piece of work.
So what's that? Love